Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as Tube 87. And to those keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. I hope you're having a happy and a blessed Sabbath. Now, let me say this first and foremost. This study is not about homosexuality. I repeat, this study is not about homosexuality. The reason why I used the clips and everything that I did at the beginning is because the gay rights movement is being used by the enemy to persecute believers now under the guise of providing equal rights and equality for all. The enemy is pushing forth his agenda of persecution and trouncing the Father's word at the same time. And it's a beautiful setup because he gets to kill two birds with one stone. Now, so simply put, this lesson is about how the enemy uses man to push forth his agenda. See, because we understand that they're believers and there's a world. So there's always a conflict there. And the enemy is always busy figuring out how he's going to use one against the other, because he wants to destroy us all. Now, those in the world are easier prey than those who are in the Word, because those in the Word have more of a protection from the Father, some more than others. And those in the world have little to none. So those in the world are easier to use to push forth his agenda. And like I said, because the gay lesbian movement are seeking equality through marriage, through everything, currently is being used to push forth equality in services. Now, those who provide services are standing on their religious beliefs and morals by saying, I can't provide such and such service because it goes against my religious moral belief. And they are well within their right to do that. But man is coming behind them, following the lawsuits by those being denied the service. Man is coming behind them and saying, well, no, you're violating our law, man's law. Therefore, we will persecute you, fine you, put you in jail, shut your business down, etc., etc. Or you're going to provide these services. They're telling believers that they have to leave their beliefs at home, their religious beliefs at home. Now, the Father's word says that we are to follow man's law. We are to follow the laws of the land, no doubt, unless they violate his law. Now, man is saying, you are to follow all my laws, irregardless of what you want to stand on, religious beliefs included. So now we have a conflict. Am I going to follow the word, or am I going to follow man's law? If I stand on the word, man's law is going to persecute me. But look at the flip side. If you follow man's law, your end is going to be a whole lot more costly than it is now. But those choosing to stand on the Father's word are going to be persecuted, are being persecuted, and everyone involved is being used by the enemy. So there's a choice that believers are going to have to make, standing on the Father's word or take the wrath of man and his persecution. This is what this lesson is about, persecution, and how those involved are being used to push forth this agenda by the enemy himself. Now, the trick in all this is that it's all being done under the guise of civil and constitutional rights, while at the same time disregarding the religious rights and morals granted by the Creator himself to all, upon which this very Constitution was founded and this very country was founded on. So figure that one out. There's a contradiction right there. Secondly, it is being illustrated to us that man is saying his laws supersede those of the Creator himself, our Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Now, so the loser in this gets to be those standing on the Father's word. And also the Father's word gets trounced upon by those pushing for man's agenda. So once again, we see that man will change or manipulate his own law to suit his needs, while at the same time persecuting believers and rebuking the Father's law. Now, this is being done in the guise of protecting and providing equality for all. This also creates a further separation between believers and the world at the same time. It just grows that separation and make it that much more difficult for the world and believers to coexist. But believers shouldn't be surprised, because this is the same thing that's been going on forever in recent history, in ancient history, and today in countries all around the world. This country is going to be no different, and we see it. It's starting. But the interesting thing is, we have to realize that it's going to become bolder and bolder and more in your face with the persecution, with the stepping on the religious beliefs that this country was allegedly founded on. Man's agenda is going to become the same here as it is all around the world in terms of persecuting believers. Go with me to John 15:18. John 15:18 reads, and keep this in mind, believers, don't be surprised. 15:18 reads, if the world hate you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you. Go with me to Matthew 24:29. It reads, it says, then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and they shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. It's coming, people. Some people will lose their lives, as they have been in countries all around the world. This country is going to be no different. Now, what believers need to be asking themselves is, what are they willing to lose to stand on the Father's word and the principles that he set forth for us? We are and will be continued to be persecuted, and it's going to get worse before time ends. Are you willing to go to jail, lose your home, your car, your job, or even your life? What are you willing to lose for his name's sake? Go with me to Ecclesiastes 1:9. Ecclesiastes 1:9. It reads, it says, the thing that hath been is that which shall be, and that which is done is that which shall be done, and there is no new thing under the sun. It's all repeating itself, people. The word says there is nothing new that hasn't been done. It's going to repeat itself over again. Look, if they persecuted him, why should we be any different as believers? Go with me to Matthew 10:24. Matthew 10:24 reads, it says, the disciple is not above his master, nor the servant above his Lord. Luke 6:40 reads, it says, the disciple is not above his master, but everyone that is perfect shall be as his master. So those two scriptures, understand what it's saying. It's saying that we are no different than he, and if we're going to be like him, get ready, people, because we are going to go through it. He sent others before us, and the same thing happened. They did the same thing to him. Luke 11:49 reads, it says, therefore also said the wisdom of God, I will send them prophets and apostles, and some of them they shall slay and persecute. We are going to be no different. It happened in times past, and it's going to happen now. Now, go with me to Luke 21. I'm going to read 6 verses right here, because this is very important, and you need to understand what the word is saying. Luke 21, it reads, we're going to start with verse 10. It says, then said he unto them, nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and great earthquakes shall fall in divers places, and famines and pestilences, and fearful sights and great signs shall there be from heaven. But before all these, they shall lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to synagogues and into prisons, being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake. And it shall turn to you for testimony. See, you're going to go through these things, and it's going to turn to you. It's going to become a testimony that you have. Everything that we go through and overcome is a testimony. And some people are going to go through some of this stuff, and it's going to be a testimony to them. Now, you're going to be turned over, not to kings and synagogues, but to courts and justices, maybe even presidents and whoever's in charge, police, what have you. Same thing. Verse 14 says, settle it therefore in your hearts. Get it in your minds, not to meditate before what ye shall answer. For I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist. And ye shall be betrayed by both parents and brethren and kinfolks, and friends, and some of you shall they cause to be put to death. People, your own friends, family, whomever, they're going to turn you in. They're going to cause some of you to lose your lives, some of us to lose our lives. We're going to be turned in by any and everyone. Be in the Word, because He's not going to be able to give us what to say if we're not studying this. But see, if we're into this like we should be, when we're put before judges and rulers, the Holy Spirit is going to come in you, and what comes out of you is going to be truly heavenly. It's going to be His Word. And He says they would not be able to resist it. You're talking about power. You better study the Word, so when you start getting locked up, like some of these folks are, losing their businesses or what have you, when they're in these courts, they're going to be trying to stand on their own words. If they aren't truly believers and have studied and haven't prayed and haven't done all the things they need to, they're going to be in courts looking foolish, because the Holy Spirit is not going to come out of them, out of their mouth, and speak for them. So be ready, people. If you're going to stand on the Father's Word, you better know it. Study it. Now, the Word tells us that these things are going to happen, and who's going to do it. Now, some of us complain already about how our friends and family, co-workers, or whomever stab us in the back and talk about us behind our back. But look, just wait until they start doing this for gain, for reward, or to even save their own necks, because they're so caught up in the world that they will turn their own mother, father, sister, brother, or children in, or vice versa. If you're a parent, your children turning you in to authorities because it's going to save their life, or it's going to get them money or some kind of favor. Be ready. There's going to be no way to escape this, I'm telling you, because if those you love and trust aren't in the Word, they're going to do it. They are simply going to do it. But you know what? We aren't to be mad at them. You aren't to hate them. You aren't to be upset with them. You aren't to any of this. Go with me to Romans 12:14. Romans 12:14 tells us, bless them which persecute you. Bless and curse not. And Matthew 5:44-45 tells us, it says, but I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be of your Father which is in heaven. For He maketh His sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. So, see, this isn't about them. When they start turning us in and telling authorities on us and all this stuff, this is about being like the Father. We have to be like Him. We have to let His character manifest through us. Look, as we go through these things, we have to be strong and have a continuing faith and trust in the Father in order to endure the trials. If we aren't willing to let go of the world, we will not make it. We won't make it, I'm telling you. We have to remember that our treasures are in heaven, not here on earth. That's the prize we need to be focused on, because some are going to lose their lives. And if you're still hanging on things of the world, it's going to be all for naught. 1 Corinthians 4:12 reads, it says, being reviled, we bless. Being persecuted, we suffer it. So when you're being persecuted, if you are truly faithful and in the Word, endure it. Suffer it. It means endure it. Go through it. Don't fall into the belief that it's going to get better before the end. It's going to get worse. It's going to continue to get worse. This is going to be the cost to be like Him. See, it's going to cost to be like Him. See, we have it easy right now. We think all we have to do is, just read the Word and study the Word. But it's all going to be put to trial. We're going to have to endure it to see if it's really in us. See, we can't just say, I'm sad. I read it. I studied it. I know the Word. It has to be in us, because we are going to go through it. We're going to be tested like we've never been tested before. 2 Corinthians 4:8-10 reads, it says, we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body of the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. See, I told you, we have to endure. We have to go through. We have to know it, so that His life may be made manifest in us. That's the only way we're going to make it. We have zero power, None. Nada. We have to do it through Him. We have to allow His life to become manifest in us, or we will remain unchanged and we will not survive it. 2 Corinthians 12:10 reads, "Therefore I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distress, for Christ's sake, not for our own sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong." We're going to go through it. You better be ready. It has started here in the good old USA. They are trampling on the Constitution like it's a wet piece of toilet paper. And once they finish wadding it up and throwing it away, all that's going to be left is man's law, because they're already starting to ignore the Father's word. When a Supreme Court or state justice can say that an individual needs to leave their religious beliefs at home and compromise them, what's left? It's going to move up the chain, people. With that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Brother Lloyd, 287. I'm out.